What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? We are back once again, and we're going to be doing another review. But today, we're finally going to be doing another game review. I have been actually able to catch up on some new games, or not new games, but games I have not been able to play. And we're also going to be talking about, as you can see on the screen, Last of Us PS4 Remastered. Now, it is available for free in the App Store on PlayStation, I still believe. That's how I was able to get it for nothing, even though I still like to get the hardcover. But I'm going to tell you guys something. This is the first time I've ever played this game. I have not played it. I did not own a PS3, so that's the reason why I was unable to play it. This was during the age, not that long after Uncharted, after a few other games that came out. But first off, Naughty Dog does such an amazing job with games in general. Crash Bandicoot, Uncharted series, and now with The Last of Us, and now they got The Last of Us 2 coming out next year. I figure I'd go ahead and go over it with you guys, give you guys my opinion of everything, the story, the gameplay, just everything as a whole. And this was... I'm going to start with the story. The story itself, it got your attention very early on. I want to say in the second chapter of the game, it was a little slow. Before you meet Ellie, it was like, what is going on? Same thing with the beginning, but the beginning has such a huge impact, as you as a player, on what happened on Joel, with Joel's daughter, and then going through this story of finding, okay, there's a possible cure, and you lose your partner in crime, and then you have to protect this little girl, where basically she reminds you so much of your own daughter, and you hate the fact that now you don't want to get close to her, but at the same time you do want to get close to her because she reminds you so much of your own daughter. And the trust that goes into both these characters, and it's not just a friend relationship, it's a father and daughter relationship of them having to rely on one another. And you really get to see that, more of that connection of father and daughter sort of bond when they finally go to that college, and then after Joel gets hurt from an attack, and then Ellie has to basically not just protect him, but keep him alive. And that was actually, I think, one of my favorite scenes, was when he came to come get her right after she was taken. And I'm thinking, oh man, he's gonna mess this fool up. Like, this I was like, oh, you know, like, my mind was all over the place. And that didn't happen. And the way that it ended was, you know, anybody that's, of course, played the game, you know, there's such a big play, and now it's going 5 years after the previous events of the first game. And then now, Ellie, she's older, but does she know about what actually happened at the Firefly's HQ? Did she ever find out? Did Joel actually tell her? That was the whole thing. And I'm sitting there, and it left you with such a big cliffhanger. And I believe the other one did come out, I want to say, in 2013 or 12, I want to say, when the game officially came out. I'm not exactly sure. But it was an amazing game. Story, again, like I said, it was very... I can see why, because when it first came out, I didn't know what the hype was. I didn't really, you know, look into it. But now that I officially played it, I was like, man, I can't believe I waited this long to play the game. And I was like, damn. But at the same time, I was very happy I did, because it was more, I guess, of the wait was worth it, I guess you'd say. Because, again, I didn't have a PS3. I had PS1, PS2, that I went to PS4. But at the same time, I was unable to get a PS3 at the time. And I was just uninterested in PS3 at that time frame, because I was more of an Xbox guy back then when it first came out. But gameplay wise, it really felt like they did some Uncharted type of gameplay, especially with the way they did the some of the characters. Now, with the infected, I really wish they gave us a little more leeway with the infected, because it seemed like you could get killed really easy with the infected. And I think that's what a lot of people liked, was that you had to use stealth, you had to be creative, you had to be precise. And I like that too, because especially when you upgrade your weapons, or if you have to use certain guns, or your bow and arrow, your knife, or something you create. I love that so much, because throughout this entire game, it gives you that survival aspect of, okay, if I use this, then I have to keep finding this so I can make it again, or how long can I go if I don't use this? And they really do put that into the game, and I love that very much, because it gives you that survival aspect. And I think that's the reason why that didn't bother me so much with the upgrading the guns. I mean, the one thing I did not like about the guns is that, you know, yes, you could upgrade it, but with the slow of trying to reload it, or with the recoil, or with the precise aiming. And again, that it bothered me, but it did not bother me, because you could upgrade, but at the same time, you had to be careful with what you upgrade, because at the same time, you did not know what you were going into in the very next, like, 20 minutes of the game, when you were able to, like, you know, increase your shotgun, increase your pistol, or increase your bow and arrow, or whatever have you. And they did that all the time, and it gave you that option to constantly do that. Now, the next game, they may do that as well. They said that they were really working on stealth. There's a lot of things that they stated that they were going to be working on in the second game that I did see in the first game. There was a little lag. There was a little times when you'd be sitting there and enemy see you and they just kind of go the other way. And I'm like, I'm sitting there, I'm going, oh crap, you know, like he or she saw me, and the next thing you know, they didn't, and that kind of really shocked me. I'm like, wow, they didn't see me, okay, but at the same time, I was happy about it. And we also need to make sure that the story is just as good, and I think it will be. But again, this story as a whole was very, it was emotional, it was action-packed, it had a lot of drama. And I give it literally a 9 out of 10. There's a few things I did not like about the game. The things I did not like about the game was, again, gameplay, but then again at time frame, and then, but I liked the gameplay as well. I did not like that they killed Joel's daughter off so early, but then again, it was to impact the story. I did not like that we did not get to know more information about the Fireflies, of why they were doing this, other than, of course, to create a cure, and why, oh, we got to kill Ellie to do this. It was like, really, there's got to be somebody else that's just like her, and apparently there was not, and that's why I was just like, okay. But it wasn't really too many big things I did not like about the game. The game itself was a great action-packed story. So, guys, there you have it for The Last of Us story review. But let me know what you guys think about my personal opinion in the comment down below. Did you guys enjoy Last of Us? If you did, let me know, what was your favorite part, what made you want to play it, are you ready for the second one? If you're new to the channel, always consider about subscribing, links down to below as normal. More videos coming out of this, guys. I've been really trying to do more reviews on games and everything back to what the channel originally began on. I've been expanding, as you guys can see. If you guys are new, the channel did start off with game reviews and movie reviews, so I'm going to try to get a little bit more back to that. I've been trying to catch up in my free time. So let me know what you guys think about in the comments down below, and I'll be seeing you guys on the very next video.